People across Europe, Israel, and the world are preparing to observe International Holocaust Remembrance Day tomorrow, commemorating the millions of European Jews killed by Nazi Germany. The day was created in 2005 by the United Nations to sustain public awareness of the genocide, which studies show has rapidly declined in recent years. Special correspondent Fred de Sam Lazaro shows us one creative attempt to educate younger generations. His story is part of our arts and culture series, Canvas.
The pen and ink drawings are his trademark, intricate, layered with meaning in thousands of dots. Dots children's book author Peter Cease wants his readers to connect.
I have almost like a third language when between the minimal text and the picture I can load in some symbols and things which maybe will make you open the door or try to think about something else.
His books have a wide demographic target, young readers to teens. Many are profiles of heroic figures in history.
Galileo Galilei, who doesn't give up, and he's a genius. And it was like, the idea was like, children among you, one of you can be Galileo Galilei.
So this is my awards storage place.
He's won scores of awards, including the so-called MacArthur Genius, for books that include The Wall, about his own coming of age behind the Iron Curtain. His latest, Nikki and Vera, tackles a darker subject, the Holocaust, and a quiet hero, Nicholas Winton, who saved 669 mostly Jewish children from almost certain death.
As a young man, Nikki traveled all over Europe.
The idea came to Cease in Europe in 2009 on a visit to his native Prague, where a group of those children were retracing their long-ago train journey to England. A celebration was planned there for Winton's 100th birthday.
It's wonderful that it did work out so well, because after all, history could have made it very different.
Winton was a stockbroker in London when he heard of disturbing developments in Czechoslovakia, which had come under German occupation in the months leading up to World War II. He went to Prague hoping to evacuate children whose parents were willing to let them go to England for what they hoped would be temporary safe haven.
So he himself immediately sets up a little office, writes the lists of the children, and manages to get trains, visas, places in England they would stay with foster families.
Urgency drove creativity. Sometimes Winton faked documents or bribed Gestapo officials, doing whatever it took to get as many children out quickly before war would shutter borders.
If I bribe the train people, they will give me train. If I bribe the Gestapo person, he will be looking the other side. So I appreciate that he was creative in this terrible situation.
Winton's effort was not the only so-called kinder transport or child rescue program in the period leading up to World War II. What's different here is that once done, he just went on with life and didn't tell a soul about it.
He helped open a school, he got married, he found an old people's home. He never told anyone about the children.
Until nearly 50 years later, when Winton's wife, Gretchen, found his scrapbook in their attic and passed it on to researchers who tracked down some of his children.
And all of a sudden, they are old.
That led to a meeting on a BBC broadcast.
Can I ask, is there anyone in our audience tonight who owes their life to Nicholas Winton? If so, could you stand up, please?
And it was this video that drew Cease to one of those children, Vera Gissing, and Nikki and Vera began to take shape.
Vera was the queen of cats.
Cease illustrated Vera's idyllic life before the war, people and things she would leave behind, her parents, grandparents, her horse, and of course her cats. But Vera's mother feared the Nazis and joined hundreds of desperate parents in lines outside Winton's office in the Prague Hotel. Cease draws this in muted black, white, and blue.
He took their photographs. He found train connections. Spies kept watch.
3 days before her 11th birthday, Vera boarded a train with 76 other children, including her sister. For almost all, it would be the last time they saw their parents.
Little Vera finds family, which is very poor, but the husband says, I cannot beat Hitler, But I can at least help one child who will survive this whole time.
My biggest takeaway is how incredibly fortunate we were.
87-year-old Ava Paddock was just 3 when she boarded the last of Winton's trains.
First of all, that my mother would allow us to go. Giving up a child or children is amazingly difficult. Stops me right there even now.
Paddock was one of very few children whose parents survived the war and reunited with her in England. She moved to the U.S. and a career in education and later mental health care. She has no worries that Cease's book is too dark for young children.
Every child has understood being left out of a group, being meanly treated. To me, the book, and when I talk about it, is really a message of altruism, actually.
The book is filled with illustrations that she says encourage readers to dig deeper, even at older ages.
Children will ask questions and then you go in their direction and in as much depth as they can. But the story, you know, simply can't die, and it's going to die unless we start with children.
Nicholas Winton died in 2015, aged 106. Vera Gissing, whose own memoirs informed so much of Cease's book, suffers advanced dementia. She's 94. I reached her daughter, Nicola Gissing, in Bristol, England.
I think on some kind of deeper level, she realizes that there's something about her and something's being made and her story is still being told.
A story both she and Peter Cease say is very relevant today, a time when millions of children find themselves in migrant journeys in search of safe haven.
I realize these are all human beings who have dreams, how impossible it is for the parents, what parent would even put the children on the train or tell the children, go, you have to go now, this is the only solution to survive. All of a sudden, all these children who were crossing the borders, who were trying to live somewhere else, who were immigrants like me, it all connected.
Nikki and Vera has been translated into Italian, Chinese, Korean, and starting on this International Holocaust Remembrance Day, it is available in German. For the PBS NewsHour, I'm Fred de Sam Lazaro in Irvington, New York.
It just grabs your heart. And Fred's reporting is in partnership with the Undertold Stories Project at the University of St. Thomas in Minnesota.